Well, first, I love challenges. I seek them out. It allows me to grow and learn. And in my successes and in my failures, there's always a lesson to be learned. And as a lifelong learner, you know, that's important to me. Additionally, I have a hunger for excellence. It's my personal motto. And so I always strive to be the best me I can be. And part of it can be competitive, but most of it is internal. And then I just love collaboration. So bringing diverse thought processes and experiences together to come to a solution. I think that has created an environment for me that results in exceptional outcomes, and with a consistent record of exceptional outcomes, you gain that recognition. So I was fortunate enough to have a mother who kept a computer in the house. Starting out with probably an old Commodore, Apple II or something, I can't remember, but I've always been around computers. And then when I was in high school, I was also fortunate enough to be enrolled in a computer science class. And as a black kid in 1995, I didn't realize how fortunate I was to have that opportunity. And then I was told there was money in it, so that's always a plus. But now it's just, what continues to inspire me is just the ability to feel like I have a blueprint or a thumbprint in the future of everyone, or at least in the future of my organizations or any other business venture I may be involved in. And so that perpetuity of my legacy is what inspires me. So I think for me, the ultimate contribution is for people to know that personable and people with big personalities can still work in technology. Even though you may be working in robotics, you don't have to be robotic. You can be your authentic self, natural self, and creative self, and still be successful in the field. If I could leave one mark on the profession, I would leave to always help people, to always be a people person. Don't always be very methodical and thinking that your job is just coding or technology. At the end of the day, technology is about connections and connecting people and things, and therefore it's not about sitting in a room in front of a computer and tapping code. So the teacher that made the biggest impact on me wasn't actually my teacher, but she was a teacher in Chicago Public Schools, and that was my mother. From a very early age, she instilled in me my hunger for excellence. And I remember her telling me as a six-year-old kid that you will go to college after high school, you will get your bachelor's degree, you will get your doctorate degree, you will do great things. And for me, at six years old, I didn't need that push, but after that push, I never needed another. It was like I was rolling downhill from there, and I always wanted to do excellent things. And I'm not quite a doctor yet, but that's gonna be my next challenge. As far as mentors go, I've had a dearth of mentors. I really felt early on that if you were smart enough and that you worked hard enough, you can navigate this on your own, and boy was I wrong. mentorship is so important. Networking is so important. So though I didn't have many mentors, it has had an impact on my life because I can see and how mentorship really changes your trajectory. And so any chance I have, I try to reach back to those people that are coming up next and mentor them on life, family, career, school, whatever I can. Honestly, my greatest career accomplishment is receiving this award, and that's no lie. I've had a lot of school, I had a lot of scholarly awards, but this award has been the culmination of everything that I've worked for. I'm a pretty humble guy, I don't need a lot of pats on the back, but with that being said, a lot of the achievements I've made have been credited to other people just because of my humility. But after a while, people see you as the go-to guy for everything, and your light will shine through all the clutter, and you will receive recognitions. So, though this is my first award of this nature for my career achievements, I hope the first of many. As of today, this has been my greatest accomplishment. Thank the STEMmys and the Gaskins Foundation for giving it.